Live from Los Angeles, welcome to Good Morning Lalan. I'm Dr. Aaron.
And I'm Tanya Memmi, filling in for Rob Mack today.
And I'm Jess Moyer. This is Good Morning Lalan, America's first live streaming daily talk show, coming to you live Monday through Friday at 9 a.m. on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Twitch. Also available on Apple TV and Roku via the EverTalk app.
And it's hashtag Wealth Wednesday. We're going to be like the Karate Kid and walks on, walks off, because we've come together each day to know the truth, live on spiritual principle, have some tea, and live in the non-sunshine. I'm going to like cry pretty soon, you guys. I can't handle
this. This is not summer, seriously. I don't get it. It's freezing here in Los Angeles.
I'm moving.
Are you?
No, yeah.
Oh, well, you heard it here.
To the valley. To the valley, for sure.
We're so excited for Wealth Wednesday. We have some amazing guests in store for you today later in the show. Some incredible conversations on how they created true wealth in their life. From movies to plant medicine, we've got it all today.
Ooh. We have a lot. Yeah. We're so happy you're here.
Thanks.
I mean, we miss Rob, but you're kind of cute, you know? We're gonna keep you.
Thanks, I try.
It might be June bloom, but you are sunshine, Tanya Memmi.
So oh my goodness,
thank you for being with us.
Wow. You guys, I'm gonna cry.
No, so how was it? What was it like coming over the hill this morning?
Oh, well, it's what happened before that. It's my life is a disaster right now, you guys. I have this hyper dog that I don't know what to do with. I don't even know how to do a dog.
And oh, you still have the dog?
I still have the dog.
Did the neighbors complain?
Yes, they did.
Okay.
Well, so I'm going to get kicked out of my place before.
Tanya, bless you for accepting a rescue puppy and giving it a foster home. We really appreciate it. But we had an interesting conversation about, you know, how to create those healthy boundaries for yourself yesterday in the show. So what's your plan?
Well, I'm going to learn from everybody today to create more wealth, and then I'm going to hire somebody to watch the dog when I can.
Perfect.
So how's that?
Yes. Let's wax on and wax off, Aaron. Tell us about Wealth Wednesday today.
Yeah. So, you know, I think wealth is, we have talked about it, of course, every Wednesday on the show. And wealth, in our opinion, is really, you know, connection to source, connection to our health, connection to amazing relationships. Mm-hmm. But it is funny because I was thinking about the movie The Karate Kid. We were actually talking about it yesterday on one of our group coaching calls. And how, I don't know if you guys remember that movie, but it was a classic movie, 1980s, and it was Daniel and his single mom moved to Southern California, and he was bullied in school. And so he went to this karate master, Mr. Miyagi.
Miyagi.
You're right. See?
I saw him in a restaurant
a little while ago.
You're
dating yourself.
I am, but I love the movie, so.
So it was funny. So he goes, please, you know, teach me karate. I want to become a master so that I don't get bullied. And, you know, Mr. Miyagi was like, well, if I'm going to teach you, you need to do something for me. So he's like, well, you need to paint my fence. So he started having him paint his fence, and he was, like, slapping it all over. And he's like, no. You need to, you know, brush the fence and all that stuff.
For days and days.
And Daniel started getting kind of pissed. And he was like, no, you need to, you know, sand this thing. So he's like, wax on, wax off, all this stuff. And he didn't realize that he was training him for his mastery. And I think that that's, like, wealth. We need the skill set, we need the mindset, we need all that. And sometimes we want to get way out there and become the multimillionaire, you know, entrepreneur, but we got to wax on and wax off, you know? So yesterday in the group coaching call, the girls becoming spiritual leaders, it's really about embodying the principles and the skill set that it takes to be a master. And those are like, they seem so simple and yet they're so profound.
And very, very true. And I also think too that sometimes when I don't know about you guys, but you're working towards something, and you give up right when the going gets tough.
Right.
And sometimes there's a saying for it when you give up and then the next person comes on and takes it from there and ends up, hitting the jackpot. So just if you are experiencing that, which I kind of am right now. Right. Don't give up.
What about you, Jez? Jez is a master of, I mean, she like holds this whole thing together with knowing everyone's names and keeping this whole group grounded.
So true. You're amazing.
So like, how do you wax on and wax off in this mastery that you have over there, Jez?
Well, you know, it really starts with forgiveness for not being perfect. Because as much as I try and honor everyone and all the time that we put into the show, into this community, at the end of the day, I'm still a human. And as much as I want to be able to be perfect in that, I'm not, and it's live. So we just have to embrace our imperfections and celebrate every single moment and opportunity we have to connect with each other and to connect with you. And that's really where it all begins for me.
But like, if you didn't wax on and wax off, really, and know, I mean, you're so good at keeping track of everything that when something happens and things happen, we're live, you know, it doesn't always go as planned.
You do have a gift.
Thank you very much. Yeah. You know, I've invested a lot of time waxing on and waxing off. I went to school for broadcast journalism. I put in my time as an intern. I've worked for free. I've hustled on the red carpet. We've been elbow to elbow at premieres and junkets. I've done mean, countless hours of research, but that's what I do because that's what I love. And so, yes, I've been painting this fence for a very long time.
Right.
And you know, it's funny because everybody sees the polished, shiny, finished product, right? You see that moment when somebody wins their Emmy or their Oscar and they think they're an overnight success. Well, let me tell you, overnight takes about 12 years.
At 12 least. Years of waxing on and waxing off.
12 years of waxing.
I just put a pink cheeks in Studio City to wax on, wax off. That's
honestly,
easier for me.
No joke. But I think the question is for you is, what are you spending your time, the little things that are actually developing you in your mastery? What are you waxing on? What are you waxing off? And every day in every way, we have to think about every thought. That is what we're building our skill set around. Every relationship, we're building every skill set. So have a awareness around that today and have fun. Let's take a little break. When we come back, we're going to dive into these amazing, amazing guests here about building wealth and lives that they love. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Welcome to Your Home for Talk. I'm Jezza Moyet, and this is EverTalk TV, America's first live streaming video talk show platform. This week on EverTalk, our shows were filled with positivity, enlightenment, insta-fame, insta-scandals, and binge-worthy conversations. Let's take a look.
Today's guest dislikes titles. Although he is an amazing, talented actor, and a real-life Viking, he prefers to be valued by how many belly laughs he can get you to have in the shortest amount of time.
Hi, everyone. I'm Erin Ziering, and this is The Housewives of Hollywood. You might think you know the housewives, but it's not Rosé all day, Pilates, and finding the best nannies. It's women supporting women, and today I have a very special guest, and we might have to change the name just to Housewives of Beverly Hills for Tori Spelling.
Tori.
Thank you so much for coming on.
Oh my gosh, anything for you.
We kind of like having her here.
Yeah, she's like, so much good morning, Lala.
We've got things to do.
Room to your set today.
That's right.
I love that.
So tell us about the proper way to actually taste this wine.
Put it in your mouth.
I love you. That's my kind of wine.
LOL. As you can see, we have a lot of fun here at EverTalk TV, and I'm so excited to share this journey experience with you. Visit evertalktv.com for your free 30-day subscription. EverTalk TV, anytime, anywhere.
This is how we do it. This is how we do it.
Where can you watch the stories of people changing the world? EverTalk TV, the Netflix of talk. I'm Jezza Moyet, the co-founder and host of EverTalk TV, and I am thrilled to introduce you to America's first live video streaming talk show network.
We all crave connection.
I'm a big fan of videoing a podcast.
The impact that I'm having people on a podcast is I'm having more impact on those people than I ever did in news.
We want to be heard, but we also need to listen.
Podcasts, I understand they are red hot.
It's actually remarkable how scary to me podcasting is. Everybody should have a podcast.
I really wondered why. I mean, we've been doing this for 12 years. Nobody has done this in other arenas.
We have to change the conversation to happiness over financial success. It was like, we have to. We have to.
Honestly, it was meeting new people who had already heard about what we have done and thanking me for the contribution we're making to their lives.
Oh, nice. That's
this
great.
Is what my purpose is. This is why I was born.
Yeah.
I think this is my first time my book's been up on TV. This is awesome.
Thank you guys so much for watching. You can always find these videos and binge them on EverTalk TV. Thanks for coming. Bye.
Entertainment that will inspire, uplift, and empower you anytime, anywhere on EverTalk TV, your home for talk.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning Lala. On Wealth Wednesday, it's all about mindset. And we got a glamorous woman in the house. We have Lynn Richardson, who is a money coach or a life coach. You are a TV and radio host. You're a multiple book and mother. wife, minister, all the above. What's up, girl? You got it going on.
Everything.
Enough,
right? Oh, my goodness.
You know, it's very interesting and leads us right into the conversation about being a jack of all trades and a master of nothing, right? So how do we balance? I'm not saying you have a master at all because you have, but how do we balance all of these income streams to create the symphony that we really want?
Well, the truth is I was a jack of all trades, a master of nothing. When you would come to my house in my 20s, I could do your hair, I could do your nails, I could write you an insurance policy, teach you how to get a man, how to quit one, how to get a job, write a resume.
I love that, though.
Like, I had all this stuff. So I was very busy, but I wasn't fulfilled, and I wasn't making any money. So I was a lot of things to a lot of people, but I was going after, I was looking to make money. And what I talk about in the symphony is not necessarily finding your purpose, but living on purpose. Do what you love and the money will follow. Mm-hmm. And just like the orchestra, when you go to the orchestra, there's one instrument and then another and then another. If you do that with your income streams and you take one at a time, at some point they'll all come together to make one beautiful sound.
So how can we stop living paycheck to paycheck?
Wow, well, the first thing is to spend less money. I tell people to live by the 10, 10, 30, 50. The first 10% you tithe or give, the next 10% you save, 30% is cash for incidentals to avoid a spending addiction, which is what you have when you go to Walmart for toothpaste and you walk out with $179.47 with stuff you don't need.
Right.
And the remaining 50% stays in your checking account for your bills. So you spend less money and then you get more money. You build multiple streams of income. And then the third and most important thing is to get your money back. Most people do not realize that everybody is an entrepreneur because there are two systems in America. If you are an employee, you pay a lot of taxes. If you have a business, you pay less taxes. So those are the three ways to have more money in your pocket.
And most people listening, they're like, that's cool, but I'm in debt. So they're not quite ready to make that leap over to all those, you know, percentages.
Yeah.
So what would you say for somebody out there that it's like, I don't even want to look at this. I don't want to think about it because it's not pretty.
Oh, well, that was me. The first time I looked at my budget, I cried for 3 weeks. I was a big, let me tell you, I was devastated. I was a corporate executive, finance person, had written books, but I was crazy as all get out. And the thing is, you actually have to face it. You cannot fix what you will not face. And so start with baby steps. I looked at my budget, I wrote everything down. I was spending twice as much as I was getting in.
Whoa.
And so I had to give up some things. I had to say no to people. I tell people no is a complete sentence. When people ask you if you can do something, the answer is no.
Mm-hmm. Unless you're paying.
Yeah, right. Absolutely. Yeah, and then I had this thing called gas price distance. If people asked me to go out, if it wasn't a gas price distance, I didn't go, which meant it had to be like a block from my house. So it's really, it was tough things like that.
But this is really interesting, though, because it is a tough conversation, and nobody wants to be the friend that doesn't get invited, who can't come because she has to drive too far. But the reality is, in doing that, for even just a little bit of time, you're actually creating much more freedom for yourself.
Yes.
Can you speak to that?
Oh, yeah. Well, I didn't want a budget because I thought budgets were for poor people. That's crazy as all get out.
Yeah.
Every major corporation that has a profit has a budget. And so the idea is, you know, here's the deal. Being broke is hard work, right?
Mm-hmm.
So getting your money straight is hard work, too. Well, which one are you going to do? And I'm finding that when I say no, when I cut the limits, then usually the people around me start to do the same thing. And if they don't, if you have 9 broke friends, you're going to be number 10.
Right?
That's true.
And I think it's an opportunity to get innovative. I mean, in my 20s, I didn't spend a dime. I saved everything. And I was very thankful because it made me in a place where I was free. But I think that there's a place where you go, how can you do this without complaining? Because there's nothing worse than a girlfriend being like, well, I can't afford that. Or this is expensive when you go out and you're like, oh, this isn't fun.
Or just complaining that you don't have this, how can
you get creative and do something fun that doesn't take a lot of money? What are some ways of...
Well, you know, again, I always say if you have a business, so a lot of people don't realize if you have a home-based business, a self-employed sole proprietorship, it's not difficult. You don't have to have an LLC, a corporation. You don't have to go file permits and things like that. Most people can be a consultant at doing something.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have a home-based business, for example, I have 3 children. You get to hire your child to work in your business. I get to write off $12,000 per kid that I hire. Now the money that I was going to use on them anyway, it's now a tax write-off to me.
Another reason I'm a child.
Yeah, hang on a second. Hire your children?
You can hire your children. IRS Publication 15, the Small Business Association, everybody tells adults to hire their children. When I go to Disney World, I go for business. So I get to write off the plane ticket. I get to write off the hotel. I get to write off the, well, you can't write off entertainment now. But before, you could write off the park. You could write off everything.
Mine's 8. Is that too young?
actually, there's no minimum age. So there's no minimum age.
Wow,
harder
to work, Daniel.
People say, well, what can an infant do? The IRS says that your child has to be able to do any job that another child could do. So an infant can model, just like the Gerber baby, just like any other baby in a commercial.
She's on your Instagram.
Yeah.
She's on my Instagram. She's not allowed to have her own Instagram page yet. But yes, already been on television, but we haven't made much money yet. But
okay.
I feel bad. I feel like I'm sort of, you know, but putting her out there and going.
But you can write off your rent or your mortgage. You can write off, like, it's amazing everything you write off.
You can write off so many things. The average American only knows about 7 or 8 tax deductions. Your rent, your tax, well, not your rent, but your mortgage interest, your taxes, if you give money to a charity.
You can do a portion of your rent.
There are over 475 tax deductions for people who have a business. And it doesn't have to be a big business. Again, it's your hair business or your styling business or your production business. Any business that you have as a home-based business owner, you get access to 475 tax deductions. So for me, everything is business. My cell phone is business. I don't talk to anybody for personal reasons. Everything is business, including my children. If I have to pay for them to go to school, that's business. Everything for me is business.
So how do you talk to people personally then?
It's not your phone. Right now.
In person. But you got to
learn. We're workaholics.
Yeah,
I don't have anything that's not me.
My cell phone is for business. I don't know about anybody else, but mine is for business.
Okay.
Did you hear that, Mom? No more phone calls.
Wow, that's amazing.
I think it's important, though. I think especially as women, it's time we have to educate ourselves. We do want freedom, and I do think that it's so that we can make the right choices in our life that's not based on scarcity mentality. So thank you so much for everything that you do. How can people work with you? Find your work, find your 8 books.
LynnRichardson.com. You can find everything there.
Oh, thank you so much, Lynn. We appreciate you. Yep. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more Good Morning Wildland.
That was the curveball. Unintentional curveball.
Jeez, that was the rush.
You scared me.
I was like, okay.
3, 2, 1.
Wow.
Good design.
Okay.
Now
show
the camera.
Up to you to choose the winner. Is it Annie? Is it Haley? Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning La La Land, supporting moms in one of the most challenging times in their lives. We've got the founders of a new app, Juna Moms, with us, Sarah and Haley. Thank you so much for being with us today. So a dear friend of mine had introduced me to your concept, and she's just given birth to a brand new beautiful daughter, but it is one of the hardest times in her life. So how are you helping guide these women through that?
Yeah, so I guess I'll back up a little bit, but we created Juna with the very purpose of giving moms a fitness and nutrition experience that's dedicated to them during this very special time in their life. Because when I was pregnant, I had a really hard time finding workouts that were like hard, but still very safe for pregnancy. Mm-hmm. And the same experience for postpartum, it was all focused around getting your body back and not centered around the fact that, you know, you just were pregnant for 9 months and you just pushed a baby out, and that maybe you have urinary incontinence or you have diastasis. Like, there's all these things that happen, and these fitness products were just very focused on the wrong things. And so that's really what Juna is. Like, we created it for this very special period in your life. And so it's just for moms and pregnant mamas right now.
So important. Is there a community involved? Like, so if someone gets the app, They're working out, they find a nutrition. What else is there for them?
Yeah, so we have a private Facebook group right now just for the Juna moms so that they can talk about their experiences, which is like, I'm sure you can say the same, like much of being pregnant is kind of being like being in it together and being able to, I guess, complain a little bit, but but also like just, yeah.
Well, when I was pregnant, I hadn't had any friends that were close to me who had gone through that experience. And I felt kind of alone in that time. And having a community of women to troubleshoot, bounce things off of, you know, having us in there who have been through it. I have three children now.
Wow.
Sarah's a mom of two. So we've learned, you know, a few things along the way. Mm-hmm. So having that experience to help other women who might be going through it for the first time or, you know, just want to talk about their kids or things that are happening to them after they become a mom. I think it's really important, the mom community. I felt that I connected with moms a lot online versus in my life because I didn't have that through social media. And we also have an open Instagram account where we like to share a lot of nutrition information and stories. Sarah hops on there all the time. She's certified in prenatal fitness. So she goes through workouts and shows modifications depending on what time or where you're at in your pregnancy, different types.
I love that you mentioned the nutrition because that was one of my favorite things on the Instagram. Just keeping it simple, eat this, not that. Because a lot of people don't know what's okay. I feel like I'd be scared to get pregnant because I don't have all the information and I would have to read a dozen books before I felt like I was ever prepared.
You know, what's interesting is when I was pregnant, I didn't want to eat for the first three months. It was really weird. I had a hard time. And I didn't have anywhere to go, not knowing if that was normal or not. And then all I wanted to drink was milk.
Yep.
I had no idea why. Jugs of it. And then I overate during the last trimester. So how do you deal with people like that, that actually have an issue with eating in that sort of way?
Yeah, you know, I was the same. Like, I struggled with fueling my body properly. Like, I was eating lots of mac and cheese, and I had a lot of guilt around it because I was just like, I know this isn't great for my baby. And I just, if someone told me, hey, in week 12, like X is going on with your baby and it's really important that you get high fats because there's brain development. I would have been like, okay, I will do whatever I can to get this in right now. And that's what the app does. So week by week, we give you a nutrition focus with a nutrient and then a bunch of recipes to get that in. And we have a lot of smoothie hacks because, like, as you know, like it was just tough, especially in the first trimester.
Hard,
And then in the last trimester, you just don't have a lot of room. So if there's a way to pack in that nutrients with small amounts of food and smoothies, it's perfect.
I was so ill. Weird things too. Like I was dying for the smell of Freon. my air conditioning unit. I wanted to stand in front of the air and just breathe it in, and then the freezer. Have you heard of that? I'm telling you, there's people out there that have
learned something new.
Yeah. But at least if I had your app, I bet you I would have found somebody I could talk to about it.
Yeah. Well, I think the great thing too, that funny things happen like that. We get moms asking us new questions every day, and if we don't have, I have never heard of that.
I have.
But I feel like everything is normal in pregnancy because your body is going through such a funny, strange. Your hormones are all
very
over the place,
dogs.
So.
Mm-hmm.
I ate five corn dogs in one sitting.
It was weird and laughing. It was just weird. Anyways, I just love that you guys have this app because I went through a very strange experience, you know, being pregnant.
I think for anybody, it's a very strange experience. Mm-hmm. You know, your body's never been through that until it's been through that. You don't know.
You don't know your first time. Yeah.
Want and how to really.
Scary.
And it's different every time too, as you know, like that's the interesting thing is that it's like my pregnancies were so different, what I experienced was so different, and so I think that's what's been so much fun about the app is that we've come up with new things for every pregnancy, and then we tap our friends, we're like, what are you going through, what are the questions you have, and how can we be
so good.
A resource?
So good.
Well, it sounds like an absolutely incredible community. Please tell everyone where they can find and follow and get involved.
Yeah, you can follow us on Instagram at juna.moms. We have tons of recipes and fitness advice and nutrition advice and then all things pregnancy and postpartum. And then you can download the app in the iOS App Store. Just search for Juna.
Cool.
Thank you so much. Stay tuned. We'll be back more. Good morning, Lawland.
I can speak is count up to 10 in like 5 or 6 languages.
Oh, that's good.
But I can't speak any other language.
I'm introducing an Emmy Award-winning host. I better freaking get this right.
You knocked it out of the park. You did a great job.
Does this tent look weird if I in the end the shot, I suppose?
Yeah, that looks
good. That looks good. Who's this? Can you get out of my way? All right.
I'm so grateful my boobs did what they needed to do.
Right.
They got me my man, they fed my kids, I'm good.
Right? I hope you're filming right now.
The other thing, I'm going to take
that. Yeah, I'll take to that.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to hashtag Wealth Wednesday on Good Morning Lala. And I'm so excited to welcome Abby Freeponk to the show. She's the CEO of Duple. Tell us all about this super fun new app.
Yes, absolutely. Duple is a brand new app where people can create challenges either for fun or for social good. And we have a three-pronged approach. So individuals can create challenges to challenge your friends for, you know, motivational Sunday something or Wednesday. You can create challenges for nonprofits. So a nonprofit can come on the app and do awareness raising or fundraising. And then, you know, corporations can also create challenges, you know, for corporate social responsibility.
Oh. So the famous app. One was the ice bucket challenge.
Yes.
Is this similar? Can we create something like that?
Absolutely. So I spent 17 years in the nonprofit world doing fundraising. Mm-hmm. And it was really hard work. I always had to go out and ask for money, and I could only focus on whatever our initiative was at the time. And then I was actually in Cambodia doing some work there, and the ice bucket challenge happened. I went, oh my God, this is a good way to actually clone myself and do this. Yeah. And have charities actually tell people why they should fundraise for them, right? Mm-hmm. And so this is why, you know, basically the seed was planted at that point, and I thought, we really need to find a way to use technology to make this a little bit easier.
So what are some of the challenges people have done that are fun?
Oh my gosh, the one called Jump for Africa, I was actually talking about it this morning with some folks in the studio, and it was just about, you know, what book did you read when you were a child that you loved? Right? Mm. So it's that kind of nostalgia over there. And what they do is they take used books and donate them to kids in impoverished countries, Africa and other parts of Asia.
Wow,
and so,
beautiful.
You know, they took the idea of raising money, but then they created something fun out of it that everybody could relate to. Everybody loves, you know, everybody has a favorite book. Everybody has a favorite childhood book, right?
Rob Mack would definitely have a two cents on that one. He loves books.
So, or a book that changed your life or inspired you.
And so many.
It's a good way to inspire other people to read and to learn without making it heavy. Because I feel like fundraising and nonprofit stuff are not always fun, right? If it's about cancer, it's heavy. It's tough to talk about. But the Ice Bucket Challenge taught us that we can find a fun way to talk about some of these really difficult situations and encourage one another to keep fighting.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to have to create one.
Absolutely. Well, actually, she's created one around Wealth Wednesday for us.
All right.
I did. Oh. It's called What Motivates You.
Oh.
And so I created that challenge, and I'm going to look for it right now, of course.
What motivates you? What motivates you, Abby?
All the people that I work with. Mm-hmm. You know, we're all different, and I'm you know, I'm a list maker, and I'm really super organized, and I work with a lot of creative people who I have, you know, zero creativity. I look at their process, and I think, oh my God, that's brilliant. How did you come to that conclusion from where we started? Because that's not how my thought process worked. And it's taught me to really appreciate, you know, our differences. So that's
tell us about the challenge and how we get involved and make this happen.
So Duple is on iOS and Android. You can download the Duple app and just search for motivation, and it's going to come up, and take a photo or a video of someone that motivates you or something that motivates you. Upload the proof, and you can win some free Duple swag.
Oh, that's fun.
I love that.
I actually want to do 3 giveaways for this particular challenge, so I hope you guys can join.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm.
So I can take a picture of Jez and just upload it.
If she's a person that motivates you,
intros and outros. So tell people where they can find and follow and everything.
Oh, so great. Duple is, we're on Instagram, Duple. We're on Facebook. We're on Twitter, we're on all the social media handles, because Duple is a pass-through platform. So whatever you create on the app, you can share with your friends on social media and then draw them into the app so they can follow and see what you're doing. It really allows you to eliminate all the other noise, right?
Cool. Love
it. So you can just go on there and just focus on the one thing that you're trying to get to that day.
What is the one thing you're trying to do with Duple? What is your mission?
My mission is really to allow the nameless, voiceless people that are trying to make a difference in the world to have a safe space to do that. Because Duple is really just for fun or for social good. You can come on there to do anything else. You take a photo or a video, that's it. So we've limited it so that we can really try to shift people's focus on gratitude, motivation. Let's pick out the one thing that you're good at and just focus on that. Because right now, when you listen to the rhetoric, we always want to talk about things that people are not great at. Why don't we pick the one thing that you are good at and start mm-hmm. encouraging you from that point on, right? And then it's going to create a ripple effect.
So then you can duplicate it, just saying. So.
Duple.
Thank you. So how can they follow your personal journey as well?
Oh, I'm on Instagram, abby.frimpong, so you can find me. It's pretty simple.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Better make me look good, Andy.
Guys, I'm a witch.
I can't see you.
Yeah,
really
too.
We look amazing, that's all you need.
You do? Know. Terrific.
I call myself different things all the time.
Oh my
Alchemist,
God.
Witch, creative coach.
Like, what is it really?
Can I call you a witch?
Yeah, and this is witch, Lauren Mullet.
Yeah.
I'll just be like, I'll
Why not? Do you want to make CEO into a show? Not that we spin off from here.
Yeah. This is birthday girl Emma David. And what she does is irrelevant because who she are is what matters.
Do whatever you want. Who she are, don't say that.
You know, Andy, that's what you get for not having coffee with us.
Yeah.
Everything comes down to what you do.
Don't save it for the camera.
Okay.
Unless you're shooting bloopers, in which case it's okay.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning Lawland. We are here with Keith Sutliff. He is a writer, director, actor, producer, all-around filmmaker off a new summer hit, The Refuge. Thank you for being with us today.
Thanks for having me.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
It's opening in select theaters nationwide, so tell us a little bit about the film.
Sure. It's it's a film about a getaway driver based in Los Angeles. All takes place at night, and basically he gets caught up in this job involving casino heist money, which leads to things going south for him and all these people coming after him, his acquaintances, loved ones, and it's pretty much
a
general
synopsis.
We have a look
at the trailer. Let's take a peek.
The reason I bring this up right now is because I want us synchronized for this job and any job that we do in the future.
I got your money.
Good. When can we meet?
You have to have passion and dedication to run this. A lot of work, a lot of hard labor.
So these guys, they want to meet with you near Chinatown.
First little seedling that encouraged you to even start this whole idea of this movie? How did it all come about?
Right. I've always liked crime thrillers, my genre. That's my niche. That's what I usually like to do as far as writing, directing, and filmmaking. Mm-hmm. I've been in LA for about 7 years, and I've always wanted to do a movie based around a getaway driver and also star in a movie. Getaway drivers.
Looks like you did a great job.
Right, I threw myself in the mix with everything. So it's just something that's been a long time coming since I was even a young kid. And
you just knew.
Right. So now I basically came up with the idea, years ago for that. Right. And I went into development for the film back in 2016 when I was filming my first one. And I did some rewrites. And then, so it's been like a 3-year journey for this film. And we shot in September 2018. So it's about a year and a half from the script being locked to distribution now.
So, Keith, this is an independent film, yes?
Right. Mm-hmm. Yes,
so, tell us a little bit about that, because we know that making an indie film can be one of the hardest endeavors a person will ever encounter. What's that been like for you, and what did you learn from the process?
Making any film is extremely hard. The kind of saying in the business is, like, if you can make a film, it's so hard to make. It's just almost like, when it's done, it's you're just so thankful that it's actually made, because it's just so hard. On an independent level, you're constrained on things, usually budget sometimes, most of the time. Independent film necessarily just means it's independent from the studios. really. So the budgets can really range from really small number to a large number. But when you're producing independently, there's definitely you're keeping in mind budgets, crew and cast.
But what about like emotionally and mindset? Sure. We get the money is hard. Yeah, right. Money is hard in anything, but like, how do you stay focused? How do you stay motivated? How do you stay healthy and balanced during such a stressful process?
Right. Well, it is stressful. That is one thing.
Just
really my hunger to be an entrepreneur and work for myself full time. And that's what drives me every single day when I wake up is wanting to be a full time entrepreneur, which that's who I am. So.
What do you say to the writers and directors out there? Because I have a few friends that are, and they're struggling. They're amazing writers, very, very, very talented directors, but they're like, had a meeting, didn't go well, or they're just not taking it, or they're just not, but it's great work. Like, what do you say to the writers, directors out there that are, they're really struggling through it all?
And they're trying to launch, like, another project, basically?
Well, they've written a script, and they're trying to get it funding, or whatever it is. They're in whatever stage of the process that you've already succeeded in.
Good question. Basically, always have a plan B. So, and I say that because for this film, which you just saw, it actually was, when I rewrote the script, it had the same premise about this casino heist money, but it was originally taking place at a speakeasy bar with all these characters colliding into one area. But for budget reasons, with not wanting to rent out all these locations and stuff, I ended up rewriting it to where it takes place all across LA in this car, this getaway driver's car at night.
I mean, that's a huge rewrite.
Right. You know what?
And you're just like, oh, now I got to start over again, basically.
Basically, it's centered around one character now as this getaway driver, which he was in this script originally with four other characters. So answering your question, yes. So like having, because of that, I went to a plan B, and I think it turned out better because of that. So I lowered the budget on what I thought would be better for putting more money towards prints and advertising and other things.
But you didn't know that at the time.
What's the mindset? Because, I mean, now what? Now you go out, and it's not like there's some, you know, formula, like this is what you do exactly. You're not going through traditional, you know, distribution necessarily and stuff like that. So what is the mindset where you go, I can do this no matter what? You have to have that mindset as an entrepreneur. It's not like you go, I get stuck because I had one bad meeting. You're like, so what? I got to keep going. You keep hustling. What is it that, like, do you have a plan from here? Is there places people can go to figure this all out?
No, I tell people in any business or any entrepreneurship you go into, you learn usually about two ways, and that's by having a business mentor or school of hard knocks, learning by experience.
Making mistakes.
Right, I learned by experience. This is my second feature. I learned on my first one. So I think learning by experience is the best thing.
Yeah.
But that's really your schooling, I think. Or having a mentor also.
Well, congratulations again on completing this project. Please tell everyone where they can find and follow you in the film.
Sure, you can follow me at Instagram at Keith Setliff, and also on Facebook, and then Twitter at KS Pictures LLC. And then the film, you'll be able to see it in theaters, select late theaters, the 28th of this month. And then also it's video on demand, like Amazon, Amazon Vimeo, iFlix, and other platforms.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah,
art is the highest form of expression.
Oh, awesome.
So thank you so much. Stay tuned, we'll bring it back.
Gratis Diaries, where we interview, I don't remember what I wanted to say.
Hey guys, welcome back to another,
where we interview game Christ.
But God, this watch is big. Look at this. How obnoxious is that? Hi, I'm wealthy. God, I just noticed on the monitor.
Where I interview top game changers in our world. No, I don't like that. What do I normally say, Andy?
One more time, Emma. That's it.
Oh, we can cut and edit. This is great.
Bravo! You rock!
LOL. As you can see, we have a lot of fun here at EverTalk TV. And I'm so excited to share this journey experience with you. Visit evertalktv.com for your free 30-day subscription. I'm Jasmine Moyer, and we'll see you next time.
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning, Lala. On Wealth Wednesday, we know that our health is our greatest wealth, for sure. And Nikki Rifkin is in the house. She has been an instructor for about 8 years, master teacher over at the Bar Method, which we all love in Los Angeles. We all need a little Bar Method for our tushy.
How are you?
Good.
I'm good. I'm taking a break and sitting on a couch and not doing bar method for a moment.
So nice. So yes, tell people out there, first of all, what is the bar method?
So the bar method is an exercise. It's done in studio using light weights, mostly resistance of your own body, and ultimately sculpting it, mostly what women want, which is a long, lean muscles and you're in really toned in your legs. We focus on your core, your seat, your arms. We're known for the bar booty. So,
right? I remember doing it years and years ago. Somehow it had some DVD. It was before, like, I think she took it to the next level. Yeah. And I think I got it off eBay, you know, this was like 15 years ago. And I remember, like, getting a chair and being in my room with a DVD and doing, like,
so
all the metal.
So we've stepped it up from
you guys have
now online.
Yes. So that was back in the day.
We actually have a look at some of the home workouts. Let's take a peek.
We were only born with so much strength. The rest, we have to build. And it should be built to last. Muscle by muscle, breath by breath. Lengthening and sculpting. Energizing and empowering. With a low-impact workout that's plenty intense. Because the best way to get the body you want is to push yourself to your fullest potential and adopt a lifestyle centered in a new standard of strength.
Wow.
Love that.
I love it. Awesome. You can really feel the shape.
It's true.
One of the things I liked and didn't expect were these really tiny, small, controlled movements. Mm-hmm. I wasn't doing like this big, expansive workout.
No.
And my goodness, I felt muscles I didn't even know I had.
And that's why it's so successful, because you're not doing any impact. It's a no impact. So it's successful for people of all ages, people that are pregnant, women that are pregnant, anyone with any kind of body sensitivity issues. Mm-hmm. From the youngest, you know, you can be there at 14 up to, I have one of my strongest clients, 76, and she just comes in a full split and is just incredible.
Mm-hmm. Hashtag goals.
Yeah.
So, Nikki, what are some kind of tips you might have to maintaining or getting that summer body so we can feel bar method?
So I feel like we spend so much time, like, always trying to get the summer body. And we all, you know, we have these goals to achieve, and then the summer comes and we stop working out. And so what you really want to remember is to maintain. So you want to hit that three times a week, at least three classes a week. It is achievable. It's easy. You can go at a lunch break, or if you're on vacation, you know, there's studios all over the place, and there's 45-minute express classes. But the best thing about the online that we have is that we have segments that are 20 minutes, we have segments that are an hour, so if you just have a little bit of time while you're traveling or you're at home, I know schedules with kids and camps and pickups, everything just gets changed a little bit.
But if you have it online, it's perfect.
You have it online.
Yeah.
Or it's like, just wake up in the morning, stick some headphones on and, you know, drop down, do some push-ups, do a plank, do a little bit of, you know, and just take a little bit of me time. It's,
and you
it's
don't
important.
Need a bar. You don't need
you
a
don't
bar.
Need a
home,
bar.
Right?
You need the back of a couch or a chair or little cushions.
Fantastic.
If you need support, and you don't need what we provide in the studio.
Yeah.
It's really easy to modify that.
How did the bar method change your life and your personal health?
So I was diagnosed after my first child with a disease in my spine, a rare disease, and I was told I wasn't able to work out ever again. I was devastated. Working out is important to me. And I found the bar method, and I thought I'd give it a shot. And I have not had to go on any medication, because it's been able to keep me open and just long. My muscles are really nice and long.
So true.
I don't,
what makes it
I
so
don't.
Different, though, than most, you know, types of
the
exercise?
Safety. The safety of it. It's really every single person that comes can be successful. We're really based. Every teacher and instructor we have, it's a 6-month training period versus other, you know, sometimes there's not so much training that comes in. So we're really well trained on anatomy and different body types and different
And didn't it stem from kind of ballet and then it went into, and tell us a little bit about
so
the history.
So Lottie Burke, it came from her. She's a German ballerina, and it came from the Lottie Burke method, and it came from, you know, just really using, as you said, those small isometric moves to really maximize your full.
Wax on, wax off.
Yeah, and that's what I was going to say. It comes back to that, because that's what bar method is. It's
that's
that
right.
journey. It's not always the end product. It's the journey of the wax on, wax off.
Yeah, well, it's
we
working
do.
For you. So keep waxing for sure. So tell people how they can sign up. How can they learn about it?
So it's really easy. That's the great thing about bar method. There's studios everywhere. Come to bar method online. You'll find a studio near you, or if that's not something that's accessible, try the online classes. And I'm on one of them. Come take my class.
So great. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So nice.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Ever did in news.
We want to be heard, but we also need to listen.
Podcasts. I understand they are red hot.
It's actually remarkable how scary to me podcasting is. Everybody should have a podcast.
I really wondered why. I mean, we've been doing this for 12 years. Nobody has done this in other arenas.
We have to change the conversation to happiness over financial success. It was like, we have to.
Honestly, it was meeting new people who had already heard about what we have done and thanking me for the contribution we're making to their lives.
How nice. That's
this
great.
Is what my purpose is. This is why I was born.
Yeah.
I think this is my first time my book's been up on TV. This is
awesome. Thank you guys so much for watching. You can always find these videos and binge them on EverTalk TV. Thanks for coming. Bye.
Entertainment that will inspire, uplift, and empower you anytime, anywhere on EverTalk TV, your home for talk. Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning Lolland. I'm so excited to welcome Joan Bernie Keatings to the show. She is the founder of Cinemagic, and it is an award-winning charity that has affected millions of young people's lives. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Well, thank you so much. It's a real honor to be here.
So share with us a bit about what it is that makes Cinemagic so special.
Well, Cinemagic is a charity for young people which started in Northern Ireland 30 years ago, really in the middle of the Troubles in Northern Ireland. And the objective was to bring young people from different communities and backgrounds together and to use film as a vehicle for young people to talk and to share ideas and to engage with each other. And as you said, in the last 30 years, we have grown substantially, and we now deliver film festivals in Belfast, Dublin, London, France, New York, and Los Angeles. So this week we have a number of young people from Northern Ireland, various parts of LA, and young kids from Boston all together for a week, doing lots of workshops and masterclasses, and everything from presenting to cinematography to script writing. And it really is to give them an opportunity to really see what's possible in the entertainment industry and unlock their creativity.
And the celebrity collaborations and endorsements are unparalleled. Can you share with us a bit about that?
Well, we've just been very, very kind. We've met really amazing people who've been very, very kind to the charity. And we have incredible patrons such as Liam Neeson, Pierce Brosnan. They started this week with Colin Farrell, who did a Q&A with them. And you know, they really are incredible. And these are all people who've worked so hard themselves in the industry, so they know what it's like start and have to really work and just build your reputation. So these young people are hearing from the best in the industry.
We actually have a look at some of these special moments. Let's take a peek.
Young people have more than enough talent. It's just a question of getting them to believe in themselves, really. That's the main thing. And that is what Cinemagic is trying to do here in America, all over the place.
If you want to write, direct, produce, be in movies, be part of this wonderful world of media, then you have a home at Cinemagic.
I am humbled by all these amazing young people, their work ethic, changing the world. God bless.
Mwah. I'm really proud to be involved in this festival because it supports young people, and I am also a young person in film. It's something that I really care about.
To have taken the Cinemagic experience from Belfast to Dublin, to the UK, to France, and then across the Atlantic, and to have enjoyed so much success there, tells you something about the power of the Cinemagic brand and its enormous global appeal and potential. Thank you for supporting us, and thank you for believing in us.
So what is the most magical part of it for you? I mean, I'm sure there's so many different aspects. What is that for you?
Well, it's really seeing a young person do something they never thought they could do. So we've had amazing young people who've come through the charity who have gone on to win BAFTAs, been nominated for Oscars, which is really incredible. But equally to see a young person, you know, just come out of themselves for the first time and speak in public. We recently made a number of short films on racial discrimination, on depression, and bullying. And some of those young people who've been affected by those issues are here with us in LA. Mm-hmm. And all this week they've been speaking out about their experiences. So that's really incredible, to see young people trying something they never thought was possible.
Right, and a lot of the younger generations are moving away from TV or longer things. They're going so instant gratification on the phones and stuff. So it's great that you're keeping the art of film alive. It's such an inspirational part of our culture.
Well, I think storytelling is so important. Mm-hmm. And for young people to realize they have a voice and they have something to say. You know, tomorrow night we've got a gala in Santa Monica, and these young people are performing tomorrow night.
Aww.
Oh, but wow. None of them really are singers or dancers, but again, it's just breaking down those barriers to say, you know what, I'm gonna give it a go. Mm-hmm. And try something.
That's so
I think
great.
You know, watching that, and as you say, just getting them to try things that they're not just constantly on their phone.
Wow.
And thinking that's the most important thing.
Who qualifies for something like this? Like, and what ages, and how do they get involved with the charity? Like?
So Cinemagic, we work with young people aged 3 to 25.
Wow.
And it's young, we work with a lot of schools, but also a lot of community groups. So we've been doing a lot of work in various parts of LA, such as Watts and numerous different areas. And 3 years ago, we were making a feature film, and we took a group of those kids to Belfast, mm-hmm. to be part of making the
nice.
Feature film.
Mm-hmm.
So they all ended up with professional credits on a feature and got to work along with the best profession.
So it's an actual program too, that?
It's a full program of educational screenings, outreach activity, but also practical masterclasses, mm-hmm. and practically filmmaking opportunities.
And then all the money raised goes back into
into the charity.
Nice. To making movies and classes.
Absolutely.
And, oh, this is,
you know, but this week is really important. You know, watching the young people, say, mm-hmm. from LA, Northern Ireland and Boston, mm-hmm. you know, come together, we put them on one big bus, they go around LA, and it's the best way to yeah. form friendships.
Yeah.
And we're all
and learn.
Together and to learn.
That's mm-hmm. fun.
You are yeah. really making magic a reality.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you yeah. for your work. We're so excited to celebrate you. Please tell everyone how they can find, follow the journey and get involved.
Cinemagic website is www.cinemagic.org.uk. And, you know, we work with 40,000 young people a year, but I want to double this figure in the next couple of mm. years. So please, please get involved. Oh,
so awesome. Thank
you
so much. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Close the door. Lift a crack open. I couldn't ignore the fact. That was the curveball. That was the curveball. Unintentional curveball.
That was the rush. You scared me. I was like, okay.
3, 2, 1.
Wow.
Good design.
Okay.
Now
show
the camera.
Up to you to choose the winner. Is it Annie? Is it Haley?
Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning, Lala. And on Wealth Wednesday, the reality is that we have nothing without Mother Earth. And it's really important, the work that these incredible people are doing. Floresta Organization Association deals with the Amazon, right? So I want to introduce you correctly, Franziska, and then introduce your guests here.
Yes, so I'm Franziska Freitag. So nice to be here. Mm-hmm. This is Matsiniya Wanava, the chief and spiritual leader of the village of Mutum from Brazil. And this is Irina Oliveira. He also lives there with them now. She's my project manager of the nonprofit and also nice. Translates for me in these cases.
So please tell us your mission.
Our mission is to give those a voice who don't have a voice, which literally is the plant kingdom on this planet, the Amazon itself, but also the indigenous people who live there, who I believe carry so much wisdom and connection that so many people in our Western world have lost. Mm-hmm. And for me, founding this organization together with Matsini really gives the foundation to express these important messages. And we are built on 3 different pillars, so we have different aspects we focus on. There is one, the first pillar is the environmental projects to support sustainable energy, waste management, clean water, all these things. And the second pillar, super important for me too, is the cultural aspect. So really make sure that the language doesn't get lost, the songs, the culture, the traditions get shared and passed on to the younger generations. Mm-hmm. And then the third aspect is, like moments like these to raise awareness, education, because most people are not even aware of what's happening in the Amazon. Mm-hmm.
So I'm very curious, Mazzini, what do you think we've lost in the Western world and how can we find it again?
Eu quero agradecer assim, pela oportunidade de poder estar participando desse momento aqui.
So first he would like to say thank you to be here.
Mas o que a floresta ela agora ela está cada vez diminuindo mais.
So the forest is getting smaller every time.
E o que a gente tem a visão agora é de proteger o que a gente tem.
So our vision now is to protect what we have.
E como povo indígena, a gente já vem protegendo isso muito tempo, mas a floresta ainda continua sendo uma ameaça muito grande para o desmatamento.
And as indigenous people, we have been protecting the forest for a long time, but it's still in a big danger.
Então agora nós estamos atrás de apoios para poder preservar essa floresta, porque agora ela não é mais só uma floresta para o povo indígena, mas sim para o planeta, né? Não é que a floresta vai ajudar a sobrevivência do planeta, mas ela também está contribuindo muito. Então agora já não é só para nós, a gente está como para proteger.
So now we are looking like for help to protect the forest, because the forest is not only for us, it's for everybody, and we need to work all together to protect this. And the forest, it's something like a gift for everybody.
E a nossa mensagem é a proteção, né, para a floresta, também para os povos indígenas que já há quase tempo desapareceu.
And our message is like a protection for the forest and also for the indigenous people that nearly disappear in the planet.
Right. So I think it's important for people to realize out there that the Amazon is like 20% of all oxygen and sustaining to the planet, supposedly, potentially comes from there. So if we don't take care of the forest, we potentially will not survive on this planet. So we just go through our day and we don't think about what the cause and effect is that we're up to, and it's important to support organizations that are sustaining. So how does your organization actually like protect the actual forest? Like, how do you do that? Because isn't it hard? Because people are coming as entrepreneurs and trying to get the forest, right?
Yeah, I think it's really depending on the different areas of the Amazon as well. So for them, which we were starting right now, the projects with the Yawanawa, they're right deep in the Amazon, so it's more protected. Their land is more protected than tribes that live right on the borders of different countries. Mm-hmm. But for us, it's really to start with small steps, which is the education as well as the people that we bring there to understand the importance of it, which, for example, the waste management. Like, this is, you know, something that is so small, but it has such a big impact because, like, these people, and it's quite a fair bit, they don't know how to sustain the waste, you know, but mm-hmm. then they are so connected with the Western world, so then there's a lot of plastic happening, and what to do. Like, we in the Western world haven't really figured out what to do with all the plastic everywhere, but what should these people do? Mm-hmm. And that, for me, for example, is a really, really big step, isn't like how to protect the Amazon is to make sure that they live sustainably in the villages as well and get the education they need, and we bring in the resources to make sure that the waste gets dissolved in a proper way and doesn't, you know, disappear in the middle of the Amazon, which in fact doesn't help the planet at all anyway. Mm.
Are you also looking for experts and people that can come and teach?
Absolutely, yeah. Excuse me. Anything from permaculture to waste management to education in general. We are always looking for volunteers or experts and sharing their resources and sharing their wisdom with us so we can help them apply it. And what's really interesting about this major project we're starting with is that we are using Mutum, which is the village, as a pilot project. So right now we are trialing and erroring a lot of different projects. And then once these are, you know, built in perfection, we can adjust everything we need and move that pilot project to the other villages of different tribes as well.
Well, thank you so much for bridging these worlds and helping us share the magic of the jungle. Please tell everyone where they can get involved with your program.
Yes, so please reach out on any social media platform privately to me, Franziska Freitag, or also our website, www.florestaassociation.org.
Thank you.
Thank you so much,
all of you, for being here. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more on Good Morning Lawland.
Usually I don't mess up my own intro. I'm Marissa Zanuck. You're watching The Gratis Diaries, where we interview... Wait, I don't remember what I wanted to say.
Hey guys, welcome back to another... Again.
Where we interview game... F***ing Christ.
But, God, this watch is big. Look at this. How obnoxious is that? Hi, I'm wealthy. God, I just noticed on the monitor.
Where I interview top game changers in our world. No, I don't like that. What do I normally say, Andy?
One more time, Emma. Sorry. That's it.
Oh, we can cut and edit. This is great.
Bravo! You rock!
LOL. As you can see, we have a lot of fun here at EverTalk TV, and I'm so excited to share this journey experience with you. Visit evertalktv.com for your free 30-day subscription. I'm Jasmine Moyer, and we'll see you next time. Live from Los Angeles, welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. On hashtag Wealth Wednesday, we are celebrating community with Chris Chambro. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thanks for having me.
And for sharing
Thank
this
you
awesome.
So
oh my
much.
Gosh.
I have to say this is amazing because it says our suggestion. It says our source is to be used as a tool for human connection. And when eating, find a partner or ask the question, if you could give credit and thanks to one person in your life that you don't give credit to, thanks to, who would that be?
Who would that be for you? No, for you.
No, I'm asking you your own question.
Today, in this moment, oh man, I have to answer this question a lot, so this is difficult. You know, I'd say today, a man by the name of Ryan Sweeney, he was a man who, in between two dark chapters of our life, reached out and said, let's do something together. We ended up collaborating on a great theater project, and it was the first time that our dinners had gone out of New York City and into a different territory, and it was kind of celebrated the launch of the next chapter of our life, and I'm going to see him tonight. He's actually coming to one of our dinners here in LA, and I just really haven't told him that.
So, Broadway producer, keynote speaker, sought-after dinner host, how did pastas save and change your life?
So, in July of 2015, we had just come back to New York City after producing a Broadway play in Italy. And when I got back to New York City, I essentially realized I felt four things. Lonely, unfulfilled, disconnected, insecure. We all feel lonely. We all feel one of those four things. Out of that darkness, accidentally invented a pasta sauce recipe and figured I should probably feed it to people, see if it's even good or not. And we started hosting dinners. And every dinner was the exact same. Simple pasta sauce, some delegated tasks and shared activities, empowering the attendees to work together to create the meal. And we'd ask the same question every dinner. If you could give credit or thanks to one person in your life that you don't, who would that be? And we found that a lot of people positively reacted to that experience and kept up the dinners. And we've since sparked over 350,000 relationships around the dinner table using this simple pasta sauce, a tool for connection.
Wow. I love that.
I love that. So it's not, was this your secret recipe? Was this a family?
It was my secret recipe. And the funny thing is, Cornell University did a study in 2015 that showed that firefighters who eat spaghetti in the firehouse actually perform better as a team. They would save more lives. And so there's a power of, right, we live in a world that's filled with filters and you can put up a facade on Instagram. What does it mean to remove those barriers, bring humans back to the basics of pasta sauce connection in the dinner table?
And you're bringing pasta and bread back. Come on, like, we love you.
Yeah.
Like, I don't like this whole no carb thing. It's not working for me.
It's, you know, it's interesting the amount of people who walk into the dinners and originally say, you know, I'm gluten free, or, you know, I don't know if I can eat all this bread and carbs. They actually find that when they go through the experience and actually eat the bread and eat the pasta, it cures something in their heart, mm-hmm. which is far more valuable than what they were trying to cure just by their diet, right? A whole holistic health experience that we've heard so many times mm-hmm. today talk about wealth and health is so much broader than that. Loneliness is unfortunately the greatest epidemic we feel our country mm-hmm. faces today.
Totally.
The Surgeon General of the United States says that 51% of the American workforce reports being lonely on a consistent basis. Mm. That's equivalent to the reduction of lifespan of 15 cigarettes a day. Seven years off your life.
Just crazy.
All of us are feeling that, right?
I agree.
And so if you could just move that needle a little bit through carbs and connection.
You're taking it beyond just the pasta sauce. You have a podcast as well.
Have a podcast.
Talk about that.
So in the last couple of years, we've been privileged to ask this question of connection and gratitude to a great deal of people. And at the beginning of this year, we realized we've asked so many amazing people and have heard so many great stories of gratitude and connection and overcoming fear and insecurity and all these kind of great things. Why haven't we written down any of the answers? And so we went off and started studying this question, and we're able to tell a lot of great people's stories through this podcast. Essentially, what we found is this entire world is craving empathy, right? Empathy is being talked about mm-hmm. everywhere, whether it's mm-hmm. President Obama, mm-hmm. the Pope, or the people next door. And empathy.
There's a lack of it, though.
There's a lack of it. And
seriously,
so empathy is like that end of the road noun. In order to develop empathy, you have to take action. And our core hypothesis right now at our company is that giving gratitude to others in small group format using this question is a tool to develop empathy. It'll help you become less lonely. It'll help you actually perform better as a team. And it's actually great for business.
I love that. Our team hypothesis.
We go into some of the biggest, most successful companies in the world, and their core issue that's separating them and billions more in revenue is just team performance. And it's their connection with their customers. When you bring emotion into those relationships, you increase everything.
Do you eat pasta while you're doing your podcast?
That's a great question.
What's your favorite kind of pasta?
My actual favorite kind of pasta is cacio e pepe. We use this amazing cheese that we import from Italy through forevercheese.com.
So it's a whole thing now. Your company
there's a whole bunch of different divisions at the company, and we get to serve some pretty good people.
So, Chris, why 747?
So 747 is not affiliated with Boeing at all. I have to say that on public TV.
His mission is a big jet.
Exactly.
The hypothesis is this, the vision is this.
Right? No, at our very first dinner in that deep, dark chapter, arrivals were at 6:30 p.m. sharp. We wanted dinner served at 8, and so we put the pasta in the pot at 7:47. At that same time, we delegated 11 specific tasks, empowering the attendees to work together to create the meal. And then we realized that 7:47 timing was the secret to our dinners. When people, instead of people just coming into a dining experience, regardless of the experience, instead of them just coming in and being served, if you can get people to work together to serve each other, you've returned people back to connection. Mm. And so at 7:47 p.m. is when the true magic occurs.
Thank you so much. I'm so excited to be a part of this journey. Please tell everyone where they can find and follow you and get involved.
Yes, 747club.org. Just email in info@747club.org, and one of the team will reach out, and we'll have a good time.
Very nice.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
Good morning, Roland. America's first live streaming daily talk show, coming to you live Monday through Friday at 9 a.m. All of today's interviews were available as a podcast on iTunes, and the whole show is streaming on EverTalk TV on Apple TV and Roku.
That's right. We're waking up the world together, guys. La La Land's not about Los Angeles. It's about the mindset of inspiration, positivity, and making connections. Have a wonderful day, and like, share, subscribe, and go find 747. And I'll see you again tomorrow. Thanks for being here.